Ayman Abu Aita, the man who recently became famous as Bruno's terrorist. When Abu Aita found out a couple weeks ago that he had unknowingly become a star in Cohen's raunchy new comedy, he was not happy. And now he's planning revenge. With an Israeli lawyer.
It's going to be a huge amount of money.
And a law firm representing him in the United States. So who's the real guy behind Bruno's terrorist? It took just a couple of phone calls, none of them to the CIA, to find Abu Aita. Hardly in hiding, but working in his supermarket alongside his two sons. In Bethlehem, a tourist center of the Middle East. Abu Aita is Christian, and he lives here with his wife and four children.
صحيح سجنت في 2003 لكن ما ثبت علي اي شيء انا من النشطاء لا مقاومه الاحتلال بالطرق لا عنفيه نعم.
But the Al-Aqsa Martyrs Brigade, the militant wing of the Fatah political party, disbanded in 2004, so it doesn't exist anymore. Back at the location where the scene from Bruno was filmed last year, a nice restaurant just outside Bethlehem, which happens to be in an area under full Israeli military control and right next to a military training base, Abu Aita says he didn't suspect anything strange at all.
يستغلوا المقابلة بالطريقة هذه يعني فعلا هذول هن اللي هذه الكنباية نفسها بجوز اللي قعدت عليها فوق يعني.
He says he feels taken advantage of.
يعني التعامل معي بجدية يعني إنه يعني يحكي عادي يعني هذه جيت أوت هذه ما حكاها من مرة هذه دخل الدخول على الفيلم يعني ورجاني اللابتوب تبعه من أفلامه ال ال ال, ال تافه هذه فبقول بكل شو رايك انت في افلام زي قلت له انا اي دونت لايك يعني مش عارف انا شو ليش جاب سيرته احنا ما لنا علاقه في اي موضوع لا اسامه بن لادن ولا غيره يعني
Abu Aita says being in the film has hurt his reputation in the community and his standing as a political candidate and non-violence activist.
لا الفيلم واضح الفيلم هو عباره عن فيلم جيز وفيلم يعني بيحكي بمبادئ وبأخلاق تتنافى مع أخلاقنا كمجتمع عربي يعني الناس بدي تعرف إنه ما يحكمه مجرد ما يسمعوا إنسان زي هذا أجا كذب الكذبة وفي ناس صدقته لا يا عمي إحنا الناس كلها تقدر تيجي تتفرج بعينها وتشوف إنه إحنا ناس فعلا ناس حضاريين
لبنى تكريري in Bethlehem for time.com
ضبط الحكاة الحينة
ويقول ملك أسامة بيشبه صاحب وسر أو باب الولي المشرف.
كمان مرة تعطينا إياه شو بالضبط هذيك.
Get out now.
The translator says, you say, get out, get out. Did that happen?
No, this not happen. Osama bin Laden, what's mean for me? And for that, I don't answer. And I think it's voice Bruno, and they cut it and put it in you.
Afterwards?
Yeah, after.
It's described that there is a bodyguard with Ayman. You are the man with Ayman, so are you a bodyguard?
No, I'm not a bodyguard.
What are you?
I'm a journalist.
Both men say Sacha Baron Cohen has insulted the Palestinian people because they'd cooperated in order to highlight the problems ordinary people face.
We don't agree to put my name and the Palestinian name in film like his film, bad film.
You regard that as an insult?
Yeah.
He's now hired a team of lawyers in Tel Aviv. Legal proceedings are underway. Tim Marshall, Sky News, in the West Bank. This was the location, the Everest Hotel. The film company hired it and brought in their equipment. It's 50 meters from an Israeli checkpoint. Ayman Abu Aita is in the Fatah party. He was jailed by the Israelis on charges which were never proven. He was released after 2 years. The film fails to identify him as a Christian when the character Bruno asks him about the Muslim Osama bin Laden.
Your King Osama looks like a kind of dirty wizard or a homeless Santa.